I has cleavage.
Welcome back. It's Blue Cannon, stand mission for the PC. Dream sequence.
Hiya, Grigoyo.
Someone is shaking me.
早く行かないと日が暮れちゃうよ.
Yeah, that's when Pedo Bear comes out onto the streets. A familiar voice. A voice I find somehow nostalgic. Hurry where?
買い物だよ、買い物!
Shopping?
お母さんに頼まれた買い物!
Hurry up and go there!
雄一、一緒に行ってくれるって言ったよね?
I don't wanna anymore, it's too cold!
嘘つきはダメだよ!
Oh, I remember that line! Stop making fun of my nose! I don't want to have a big nose either! No way! Wouldn't that just be random? You just turn into Pinocchio and then your pants just go pfft. Like, what the hell? That was weird. Fine, I'll go. Oh, it's cold.
そんなことないよ. 雄一は気合が足りないんだよ.
You tricked me into coming out.
騙してないよ. 全然寒くないもん.
Liar, liar. Especially in that strange voice. I'll prove it's true and make it warmer.
Eh?
I'm gonna set your pants on fire.
あんな大きな針飲めないよ!
Don't be a wimp, are you too weak to handle it?
無理だよ!
Well, of course it is. Well then, I'm not coming.
だったら… 唯一だけ今日の晩御飯は… 紅生姜!
Not pickled ginger!
お茶碗山盛りの紅生姜に 紅生姜をかけて食べるの!
Everything ginger!
飲み物は生姜の絞り汁!
Ew, that sounds kind of disgusting. I'm coming!
うん!
Isn't blackmail a crime?
ねえ、唯一?
Nayuki is breathing white mist.
そろそろ行こうよ。 じっとしてた方が寒いよ。
Oh, it is it? I hadn't noticed.
早く、早く!
The shops aren't going to run away.
逃げないけど、閉まるよ。
That's true, I suppose. As usual, she eventually forces me to carry the shopping bag. If you say I must. I'm just a poor little visitor.
そんなの小学生のセリフじゃないよ!
If I refuse to carry it, I'll be kicked out onto the dark, cold night.
だから、人聞き悪いよ!
It'll be your fault if I'm eaten by a bear.
いないよ、クマなんて!
Apart from Pedo Bear, but he only comes out at night. A wolf, then.
日本中のどこ探しても、狼は出ないよ!
That's too bad.
狼もクマも、出ない方がいいよ! 出たら食べられるよ!
We spend most of our time snipping at each other like this. I've known my cousin Nike for 5 years now. We were both a bit shy when we first met, both reluctant to talk. So, how old are they here anyway? But now the situation is as you see. We've been on familiar terms now for I don't know how long.
Yokatta. Mada kitto manniau yo.
We better be after rushing like that. Hurry up and buy the stuff before they close. I shoved the bag back at her.
Katte kuru yo. Yuichi wa koko de mattete ne.
I nod in acknowledgement, and she disappears into the bustling street.
あ、そうだ!
Returning immediately.
先に帰ったら怒るよ。
I won't.
約束だよ。
Once more she vanishes in the crowd. So, I'm supposed to wait here until she comes back. Nikki sure likes to take her time choosing things. She's hopelessly inept at it. That's one thing I doubt will ever change. True, I haven't been waiting long when suddenly I hear a shrill young voice coming from behind me, immediately followed by... something touching my back. You mean crashing into your back. Or maybe I should say, someone hitting, indeed. A girl, roughly my age. My eyes wander across her face. She's red across the nose and her eyes are glistening. That means, hey, wait a second. Cafe bar? This is Japan, what the hell's that doing in English? Wait, oh I see. The Japanese is right underneath it. Because I think they just like... Well, a lot of people that only understand English for the most part visit Japan, so we might as well put up some English signs as well. Our eyes meet. By the time I realize my danger, it's already too late. The tears leave her eyes. They come pouring out, propelled by howls. Thus she cries, sobbing convulsively. Whenever dripping tears, I stand bewildered. Now we're getting curious looks from the passers-by, shoppers on their way home. I hope they realize she just suddenly ran into me and burst into tears. She sobs on, rubbing her reddened eyes. How embarrassing. You've attracted quite a crowd. I've got homework to do. But as I make the saunter off, something catches my body from behind. I investigate. The girl is clinging to my coat. I won't get out of this that easily. So, what's your name? I'm Aisawa Yuichi. She's not very talkative. With one hand, she clutches my coat. With the other, she's rubbing away at her eyes. She moves her lips as though trying to tell me something, but I can't make out the words. Her voice trembling, she repeats the sounds. Are you? She nods. Are you? Her name, I guess. What's your last name? Your last name's Ayu? She shakes her head frustratedly. Let's try again. What's your name?
Ayu.
She speaks now in a clearer, more controlled voice. And your last name? Is your last name Ayu too? How weird. She just about stopped crying, but after this, her lips start to tremble again. Can we at least go somewhere else? The crowd is still growing. I can faintly hear them whispering. It must look like a simple case of me bullying her. I certainly doubt they're looking for deeper motives. The perfect finishing blow. A line that's crying out to be misunderstood. I look up at the onlookers who are whispering louder. I'm treading on dangerous ground. Come on, let's go somewhere else. I grab her hand and push my way out through the crowd as she begins her crying again. Come on, Ayu Ayu.
Ayu Ayu
Ayu. Ayu Ayu dashes away her tears with her free hand and follows me without further resistance.
じゃないもん。
That doesn't matter. Hurry up.
どっちでもよくないよ。
And the two of us, the strange girl and I, run back to the entrance of the shopping center. Friday, January 8th. Another one of these, huh?Dream. I'm in a dream. The same as always. Forever. The same scenes unfolding as I drift gradually to sleep. I pray for just one thing as I close my eyes. When I open them, may I see a different sky.What kind of sky are you looking for, exactly? Cloudy? Partly cloudy? Blue? Red? Dark?
朝! 朝だよ!
It's the alarm! Of death. Fast forward. Time has arrived. Leave them alone.Hello! Hello! Hello! That won't be necessary, Nayuki! Just get out of here! Yes, we know! You fail!You can't find your way through a school to save your life. Then again, who can blame him? I mean, this school does look like it probably would be a little complicated. If you don't know the place well enough, you are screwed when you go into a school this big. Why did they...Well, I suppose they'd have to make schools pretty big, wouldn't they? You wouldn't think they'd be that big. You wouldn't think they'd need that many rooms. Well, yeah, apparently so. Yeah, we know. Yada, yada. The sky is filled with heavy clouds. Some part of it has started snowing. Wild crystals, blah, 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 blah. You're still talking.Get out of there! Get out of the school, man! Get out of the school grounds, Yuichi! Before I kick your ass!Remnants of the clouds which were concealing the sky attack by the freezing wind soon disappear. I'm totally grateful, but the north wind continues to howl around me and the cold grows fiercer still. I never get the snowy breeze relying on memory alone. I remember more than I thought. Blah 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 blah. Blah blah. But I don't think we need to read this scene. Or do we? This is where I came yesterday. I suppose we might as well.It was the first day after our reunion. The first place we went together after that. And... a shriek, or perhaps a miserable voice, and I am brought back to the present. Looking over, I see that someone has fallen over there in the street. It looks like she fell flat on her face.So let's point and laugh. She's brushing the mud off her clothes with one hand and rubbing her nose with the other. Incidentally, it's a face I recognize. Yeah, because who else would go up here? It looks like she hit the ground rather hard and her coat now looks rather miserable. girl, checking that the paper bag she's holding is intact, glances backwards and begins to run. Straight towards me. Naturally, she isn't looking where she's going. You're going to hit me, are you?
What?
Hearing her name, she turns to look ahead instead. Seeing me standing in her way, she begins to shout in confusion. Okay, just dodge to the side, you hold your chopsticks, okay? This being my second time, I'm naturally quite calm. Having issued my precise instructions, I promptly step to the right. And as I do so, IUV is the same way. Splat! IU groans like she's about to die. She holds her nose as she reviews it. She's unexpectedly resilient. Aw, a pat on the head. Sobbing and rubbing her eyes, she looks up at me. Don't worry, I'm not hurt. Absolutely not. Looks imploringly at me with her damp eyes, holding the paper bag against her red nose. Her voice is a bit funny with her current nasal impairment. Really? Didn't I turn to the right like I said? You went and turned the same way. You know what? It would have been simpler if you just told her a direction which to go in instead of saying something like that. Can't think that she's just gonna be right-handed. Well, everyone's right-handed, you idiot. I'm right-handed, I play guitar left-handed, but whatever. My brother is left-handed. Not everyone is right-handed. Then it's my fault, I guess. By the way, I think someone's chasing you. An aproned man is running towards us from within the shopping center. He seems to be shouting something.
What?
She spins a full 180 degrees. 180 degrees, whatever. A brief pause. Then she rotates back. She grabs my hand and starts running as fast as she can. Not again! Why me? Suddenly, I'm her accomplice. I glance around at her, our pursuer. He looks rather familiar. Isn't that the same guy who was chasing you yesterday? He's your usual victim, is he? No denying it then? Then you should try buying something from it for once. How about you check while you have your purse before you start buying things? Indeed, common sense, girl, is what you do not have. We run together to the end of the street, dodging to the right of a group of students and to the left of a trio of housewives on a shopping trip we run. Then I notice that our surroundings have changed. I slow down and look behind me. There's nobody there. Huh? In the distance, back along the path, I can see someone waving at me. The figure, realizing that I've stopped, stands there, shoulders heaving. I presume. How come I'm so far ahead? After a while, Ayu begins to run again. Well, I say run, but it's closer to our walk, and eventually she catches up. Because Yuichi is naturally taller and has longer legs than little old Ayu here. Pat on the head. She swerves uncertainly towards me, puffing out a white cloud. Oh, you're slow, you hobbit. No, it's just that you are a hobbit, and you are small and not very fast. Wait. Usually smaller. You like see smaller creatures and stuff that are fast, right? Like raptors, for example. They're not very big, but they're very fast. So doesn't really seem to apply for humans, it seems. If you got short legs, you're screwed when it comes to running. Panting heavily, she staggers up to me. No, you're slow. You shouldn't wear such heavy clothes. So you should dress for the chase. You are a professional, aren't you? Guess that's a mitigating factor. We seem to have run pretty far. I have a feeling we're not in the shopping center anymore. There's nobody else in sight for one thing. While there's still some time before sunset, there can't be that much daylight left. We've gone pretty far. To somewhere I don't recognize at all. The sun shining through the snow, which covers the foliage above us, creates a strange and unfamiliar scene. But it is familiar because we've seen it before. As soon as she's sure the man from the stall is no longer chasing her, she gleefully produces the paper bag. Checking the loot already? It's true, though. I just hope you aren't going to procrastinate before getting around to it. With this rather unconvincing assurance, she tears open the bag. The steam from within fills the air with a delicious sweet smell. What have you stolen today? I ask, trying to peer into the bag. Wait, she didn't deny the fact that she just asked, did you steal it? Brandishing the bag with a broad grin. What? Again? How? They're exactly the same! She has eyes for nothing else but her beautifully crispy taiyaki. She pulls one out with a rustle of paper. For me? Oh, why, you shouldn't have. Wait, you stole that! See you next time, viewers.